Okay, let me record.
रेडियो जिंदगी 1170 एम पे वेलकम लिसनर्स, मैं हूं आपके साथ में ईरा। शो लेके आए हैं आपके लिए प्रेम कनेक्शन। यस, टू आंटीज डबल द एडवाइस @gmail.com, दैट्स आल्सो द ईमेल एड्रेस। सो इस शो में वी काइंड ऑफ यूजुअली ट्राई एंड गेट यू रिलेशनशिप स्टोरीज एंड समटाइम्स आल्सो ग्रेट एडवाइस। एंड जॉइन मी एज आई वेलकम रेनू आंटी एंड कमल आंटी टू द शो। हेलो रेनू आंटी, हेलो कमल आंटी।
हेलो आंटी ईरा,
अभी तो मेरी उम्र ही क्या है।
No, we don't know what your umr is, but we do know that you'll be getting 1 year older on Sunday. So happy birthday!
Thank you.
आज तो बड़ी बंटन की बैठी है, बाल बुल सजा के, क्या बात है?
Thank you very much. So today's topic, it's going to be, you know, it's actually pretty interesting and there can be only, you know, I don't think there's a gray area, there's a middle ground to it. It's either yes or no. Is drama-free relationship, is drama-free love really possible? So, ya to uske liye hote hain, ya uske against hote hain.
Well, if you watch all the stuff on Netflix, then I wonder if it's not possible.
There's nothing possible.
I was watching the Love is Blind show on Netflix. Have you seen that?
No, I haven't.
Very interesting. Weird. They find their wives or husbands without meeting them through a wall. They sit in pods, these couples, and they talk, and only by connecting verbally they will then select, and then after that they go and spend time in Mexico and get to know each other. So they break them in the stages of getting to know people. Quite interesting. Now the drama is, there was no drama, there was little drama before, but now all the drama is coming since they're in Mexico. And very interesting to see that. So yeah, but our guest today is actually an author who's written several books, and she's going to talk about whether you can have drama-free love. So yes, if she's here, Miss Ira, let's bring her on. Yes, of course. Yeah, a lot of people have been waiting for the show. So
okay, well, she is here in the waiting room and she's joining. So while she's joining, let's give a little more brief about the show.
So yeah, Miss Kamal, Miss Kamal, do you think we can have a drama-free love life?
I don't think so. I think in this day and age, it'll be really tough. I mean, our time, it was different. You know, we didn't know what drama was. You know, you kind of accepted whatever was there. But now, I don't think so. But we've got the expert on our hand. So let's find out.
Welcome, Lori. Welcome.
Hello, everybody. Thank you.
Hello, everybody. Let me officially introduce Lori. So Lori Abella is a multi-awarded international leader, author, publisher, certified matchmaker, and an acknowledged expert on soulmates. Where were you when I needed you, Lori? Co-author of the 5 international best-selling books, Secrets to Drama-Free Love, Sexy Secrets to Juicy Love Life, Volume 1 and 2. And then we have Hot Mama in High Heels. I like that one. And Speaking Your Truth, Volume 3. So Lori is originally from Manila, and she now lives in Chicago with her husband, who she has manifested in 28 days through the process she teaches. So if you're wondering how you can find your soulmate in 28 days and that too drama-free, well, let's find out. So welcome, Lori. Welcome to Prem Connection.
Hello, everybody. I am so glad to have, met you here, Remu and Kamal, and
My name is Ira. My name is Ira.
My name is Ira.
Ira. Glad to meet you. So, it's funny because, I feel so much among my best friends because, I have a lot of best friends who are actually from Southeast India. And the funny thing is that two of my best friends are originally from India. So, they flew to Puerto Rico during my wedding. And, of course, I'd like to acknowledge you for having this show, and you just cannot imagine how many singles you're helping because we are considered the unsung heroes of this industry because we're helping all over the world, all over the planet. So thank
you
so much.
Yes, well, thank you so much. Thank you for finding the time to come on our show. So my first question to you is, what do you mean by drama-free? Drama is interpreted in so many different ways. And we've had so many people since I posted say, really? Can you actually have a drama-free love life? So what is drama-free?
In popular opinion, drama comes free with any relationship.
That's true. That's right? Very well.
I like how you combine the two words in a different meaning. I like that. But thank anyway, you. So for me, like drama-free means you are free from contempt, resentments, and regrets. So if you're trying to roll your eyes to your partner, it means that that's a warning sign. Oops, there's drama going on. And if you are getting involved, let's say, in a love triangle, so that's definitely a drama. And we know it's fun to be, you know, knowing that there's some things like that, but we don't want to be in that kind of situation. Ooh. We just want to talk about it, you know, if we are hearing that, but we don't want to be in that. And so, like, obviously, there's always the abuse, both verbally and physically. We know that this is toxic, but, you know, of course, it's also more drama. So, like, if you always pointing, you know, your partner, you. And so what happened is that when you look at your pointing or your fingers, like the index and your thumb are pointing at your partner, but the other rest of the three are pointing at you. So you have to consider, like, what is in me? Because, like, you know, it's not all the time that there's a problem with your partner, but also there's a problem with you. So if you have lost the love and respect, which is the basis for all relationship, it's just not just like a dating and relationship, but also even your friends, if you have lost that love and respect, then that's a big no-no. And so the relationship crashes, you know, going down. If you are always complaining and then you have stopped romancing and then you're nagging and then you're shaming and then you're fixing all the time. Like, you know, women like fixing as if their furniture is being fixed. And then also withdrawing if you don't communicate anymore. And then especially if you're emasculating men. So, like, you know, you degrade them. They don't like that. And then if you're getting angry, and also the major something which we don't all like is, you know, the concept of infidelity. So if there's unfaithfulness, then everything will just crash down. And you know, together, all of them, it's not gonna make you happy. And then when you think about it, our main purpose in this lifetime is to have a happy relationship. And you know, it's not that, you know, the relationship will just end. It's okay if the relationship ends. But the funny thing is that, you know, we don't even know what's going to be on the mind, especially of the couple. They might even think that, you know, I might hurt myself. Like, they can even, like, you know, be in drugs, or they can be drinking all the time, or they can even kill themselves, especially now that there's a pandemic. Who wants all of this happening in your life? And we all know that, you know, this pandemic is also causing a lot of failure in relationship, because they're seeing each other all the time. And, you know, we don't have any escape. You just stay at home together with them.
So let me ask you, Lori, so how do you, you know, I mean, in our generation, you know, it's you look very young, but at least for myself and for Kamal, Kamal's been married for what, 42 years, Kamal?
Wow. Yes.
42 years. So, you know, in our time, we were taught about tolerance, and we were taught that, you know, especially in our culture, you know, and in the Eastern culture, that you are married to one person and you stick to him or her and you make it work. Nowadays, the generation is not like that. So what is your advice? You know, I know you do matchmaking as well, and you've written books. What is your advice to young people out there who social media causes drama now? We didn't even have drama when we didn't have social media. So we lacked all that unnecessary drama. How do you give advice to the young generation who live on social media, which causes drama?
Yeah, I understand that. I've heard also that, you know, 90% of Indian match made is successful. So I salute all of those, you know, successful relationship which is made by Indian matchmakers. It's not just a matchmaker. I believe there's also parents match made. So, yeah. And then, of course, like, you know, for the young generation, it's interesting because, like, I try to minimize watching TV. If the young generation can minimize, you know, looking at their social media, it will save a lot of relationships as well. Mm-hmm. Because, like, people can just be vocal. They want to express themselves. And, you know, where did they usually go to? They go to social media. So, you know, it's just like TV. When you are watching a lot of TV and you see all of these things which is happening on TV, they're toxic. And so, like, you know, somehow it's being ingrained in you. So it's a matter of, like, you know, looking what is the best option for you in order to make things work for your relationship. Because, like, you know, you don't have to be focusing what were your role models. Like, you know, the children of today are mostly from divorce. You already know that 60% or 50% of the relationships now are from divorce. So don't assume that, you know, whatever happens to your parents is going to happen to you as well. And so, like, we have, you know, of course, like, we in our industry, we believe in dating coaches. If you see, you know, there is a problem, just, you know, look for help from other people. And also, I suggest young people to look after those friends who are in successful relationships, because, like, you know, those successful relationships rub into you. If you're hanging out with those who are frustrated about dating, because, like, you know, Tinder, they switch, and yeah. You know, they actually, like, you know, swipe left and swipe right. Swipe left and swipe right. Yeah, because, right. Like, we have a millennial over here. I am, like, you know, in between you guys. And then, like, you know, I'm trying to think what is the word for it. Mm-hmm. So swipe left, swipe right. So, like, yeah, it's just, like, you know, obviously we cannot escape, because that's how the culture ended up. But, you know, if you can just remain positive, because, like, you know, there is some always good men still out there. You just have to find out where they are. And so, like, you know, that's a good idea as well, that, you know, you're helping people. Like, that's how you find the good people, through right. The matchmakers and dating, you know, the dating coaches, because they're there for you in order to help you. So mm-hmm. I usually, you know, encourage young people to find the best in everything.
Almost you have to go back to when, you know, how it all started, right? Because our parents used to have a stable marriage and everything, we looked at them and we worked at it and we got a successful marriage. Whereas now, because of all these broken relationships, children don't have any examples. So you do have to look at other ways and other avenues to find that, good relationship, so that they can work on their own. It's so true.
So I'm interested also to know about one of your books you've written. You've written Hot Mama in High Wheels, in mm-hmm. High Heels. What's that about?
So Hot Mama in High Heels is also a collaboration of different authors. So mm-hmm. Usually they were talking about women empowerment. And then, like, of course, I talk about love, dating, and relationships in all of the books participation that I have. So that is also an international bestseller. And it's always nice to be related with other women who are successful in what they do.
Do you think, Lori, that these days women, because they become so independent and they're waiting much later on, they're becoming financially independent, they're waiting much later on to find their partners. Do you think the reason why so many women are single and waiting to get married and settle down much later is because they don't feel that they need to have a man in their life to provide for them anymore?
It's not just that. You know, you have to consider, especially the millennials, they're scared. Like, I have, you know, nieces and nephews, they're scared to be in a relationship because they didn't see a good sample. And so, like, you know, in the aspect of earning a lot, like, it also varies where they're from. So let's say, like, you know, if it's in a Western country, more or less they think of that. Like, you know, I earn more money than him, so why would I be in a relationship with him? But, you know, if you consider, of course, like, where we are from, like, we're Asians, we're always thinking, like, okay, it's always nice to have somebody in my life. So, but the thing, though, is that, you know, as you were saying, the generation is always changing. Some people just are happy with their, you know, being by themselves because, like, they're financially stable. So in the end, it's interesting because, like, you know, those who have given up in marriage or in being in a relationship are the ones who actually find somebody because they're not obsessed with looking for somebody. Though if you're always looking for, like, looking for, sometimes it's just being aloof because, like, you know, you are saying, like, oh, it's never happening to me, so it's never gonna happen.
So, and I also think with the all the apps that are out there, you know, we were talking about swiping, I think nowadays people have so many choices. we were talking to someone the other day, and they just mentioned that, you know, that they have a sibling that's talking to someone right now. And they don't even want to distract him, because they said as soon as they would tell him that there are other opportunities, he might divert from the one he's talking, thinking, oh, there's something better out there. Let me explore more opportunities. So people just think they have too many choices. So moving back to our topic for today, which was the drama-free love, if you could give five or three tips even to our listeners about how do you live, you know, a drama-free life, because we're all going to get irritated with our spouses or our partners eventually, because they can be annoying. I have one sitting right here who's very annoying. So, but what would your advice be to them?
So for people, like, you know, of course, we want to go back to basics. So you have to find out, what do you really want? Because if you don't, you're not clear with what you really want, then you'll end up, you know, accepting whoever is there, because they're the ones who's available. So if you keep on accepting who's available, then, you know, sooner or later, oh, it doesn't work. Go, let me go to the next one. Oh, let me go to the next one. Because, like, you're not, you don't have clarity. And at the same time, you have to always focus on, like, you know, yourself. So, like, you know, are you in that situation wherein, like, you love yourself already? Because, like, you might not be ready, but you just saying, like, oh, I'm ready, but you are not really ready. So, you know, you have to go back to the grassroots, because, like, everything has to come back to where you originally came from. So what do you want? When do you want it? Are you ready on that time that you're looking for it? So you have to also look, like, you know, where are you looking? Are you going to the bars? So obviously we don't like those kind of situations that you're looking into the bars. And so, like, how are you looking? Are you looking through Tinder? No. So it's just back to the basics. What, when, where, how? And so, like, you know, those are just, you know, elementary for us to hear, but that's the situation right now. You have to go back to basics and find out. And so if you don't believe in yourself, and, you know, it's both men and women, they want confident person. Mm-hmm. So if you don't have the confidence, if you don't believe in yourself, then you're not going to be moving forward. You're just going to be, like, you know, one of those mediocre person. And who wants a mediocre person? Nobody.
Right. Yeah. And now with this pandemic, what other suggestions do you have? I mean, you know, where do they go looking? That's another, you know, I mean, it's a tough times right
yeah.
now.
Yeah. So for me, I always believe that love will always find you wherever you are. Like, I remember I have a friend who was taking the subway, and there was somebody who kept on following her. That became her husband. And you'll never know, like, you know, you have a computer, everybody's using the computer. And maybe this person that you call to fix your computer is going to be there, who's going to be your love of your life. Because, like, it's all about trust. Because, like, you know, that's how it is right now. We're just, you know, everybody's in the same situation anyway. And so, like, you know, of course, like, you know, you cannot escape the online dating. But of course, when you are online dating, you don't see each other yet because there's a pandemic. So you even right. ask, like, is it, oh, if you actually get to see each other, is it okay to kiss you? You have to ask permission, because, like, you'll never know, like, the girl will say, oh no, I am scared of you because of this pandemic. So yeah, and, you know, the biggest, you know, benefit of this pandemic is we go back to basics, that, you know, we woo women. Before, there was not like that, okay, let's hook up. And, you know, see where it goes. It's different now. Like, you know, everything is slow pace. Just like right. when your parents were born. Like, you know, they try to woo the woman. Yeah, except, like, you know.
Now the time is spent on being wooed. So that leads me to the next question, which Ira is just itching to ask you.
I have been, because, see, ever since in the introduction, initially, I think when we began the show, you know, you said that you manifested your husband into your life. Now, how did you know? I got hooked onto the word manifestation. How did you do that? And, you know, what would you tell others?
In 28 days.
Okay.
How did you do that?
28 days also is okay. My question is manifestation of somebody into your life. How do you do that?
Okay, so the first thing is, I was saying, like, you know, you have to surrender. For me, I have set an intention. I want to meet my husband in 30 days. That's what I wanted. And so, like, you know, just the 28 days is the bonus. So in order to do that, it's not as easy as people will think, because it's different when you say, and then, like, you know, you have to combine everything, what you say and feel and think about has to be in alignment so it can be a reality. So if you don't believe that you can manifest this person, then it's not going to happen to you, because it all starts with the belief. But let me tell you, like, you know, I was so surprised that one time I was coaching one woman, and I thought that, you know, I have marked myself, like, oh, I met this guy in 28 days. There's a lady that I was coaching lunchtime in a networking event. And she said, like, you know, later tonight, I'm going to go to a fundraising. And so, like, you know, that was the shortest period that I have seen, because she saw this guy over there who said, like, can you be my date next week for Valentine's?
Okay.
So basically it boils down to your mindset. We have a few more minutes. So it boils down to your mindset.
Yes.
In other words, you're saying you want to have a drama-free love life. You got to be free of the drama. You have to tell yourself in your mind and set yourself and align your ideas and then head for that with no distractions.
Yes.
Good. So in closing, we have three more minutes, Lori. Kamal?
Yeah, I mean, you know, besides lining yourself, I think, you know, do you feel there's anything else that you have to do about yourself? I mean, besides learning about yourself, I think that is, you know, very important that you learn about yourself, your needs, your physical needs, your, you know, your mental needs, everything, you know, when you look for a partner. Do you agree with that?
Yes. And so, of course, you also have to learn how to forgive yourself. A lot of us have made a lot of mistakes. You know, I know that, you know, in the ancient Indian culture, you know, those people who have been married are not highly, you know, acknowledged, because they have been divorced. They're not highly acknowledged. But, you know, you're not doomed forever. There's somebody for you, you know, no matter what. Because, like, you know, God listens to you, you know, wherever you are. Like, and I remember the movie, All Is Well.
So, All Is Well. Wonderful. Yeah. Wonderful. Very well said. Yeah, I like that. I'm glad you brought that up, Lori, that especially in a lot of the Indian cultures, when your marriage doesn't work out, unfortunately, it's always the finger pointing is done to the woman. We have literally 1 minute left, Lori. So if you could give people just information about how they can reach you, and also, you know, talk to you if they want to talk to you about your dating services, as well as your book on Amazon. So.
Yeah, they can, of course, look for me in Amazon. You can find one of my books, The Sexy Secrets to the Juicy Love Life, and this one, Drama Free Love. And so, of course, you can reach me at www.loriabella.com. I'm all in the social media. So Lori is Lori, and Abella is Abela. Thank you so much for all of your good deeds. Thank you again.
No, thank you. It has been a pleasure having you. Yeah, thank you. I'm definitely going to get your book and read it. And maybe that's your gift, Miss Ira, for your birthday.
Happy life. Thank you very much. I think yes, all of us need copies of that.
Yes,
thank you,
of course,
thank
yes.
you for being here. We are at the end of the show now. We are in the last minute. Any closing thoughts, Ms. Renu? Auntie Renu, Auntie Kamal, what is our takeaway?
I think my takeaway really quickly from Lori is, I think she really hit the nail on the head, is that you have to be ready. You know, you can't have somebody else come be ready for you. So when we get calls that parents say, oh, my daughter is ready for getting married, or my son, no. We need to hear from the daughter and son. They have to be ready. It's a mental state of mind. Kamal, over
to you. Absolutely. If you're not ready, you know, nobody can be more ready for you. I mean, right?
Absolutely. And I think another thing that you hit on the head, Lori, which I really appreciate, is the confidence. You have to be very confident and be forgiving. Because even if one relationship doesn't work out, it's okay. God is always listening. All is well.
Thank you everybody for being here. Thank you, Auntie Renu. Thank you, Auntie Kamal. Lori, for being here. Remember to log into the website, premconnection.com, if you are eligible, or if you know somebody who's eligible and you know, waiting to get married, looking to get married. Thank you, ladies, and I will see you next
time. And happy birthday, Miss Ira.
Thank you very much. Your birthday is on Sunday. Bye-bye. Everybody can send me wishes and presents. Thank you.
All right. Thank you again, Lori. Bye-bye. Hey.